Yes, not that I wouldn't have taken this role without a child, but it just it definitely makes it a little bit more satisfying knowing that this is an animated movie that one day I'm gonna my child is going to see. I mean, that's what kids do. They make everything just a little bit better. Everything is, you know, a little bit better. And yes, I probably would avoid doing, you know, 50 Shades of Grey Part 2, thinking that my son was gonna one day be flipping through Cinemax and see it or whatever. Not that anyone would offer me 50 Shades of Grey Part 2. By the way, if you are offering it to me, I accept. I'm getting a crash course tutorial on the fanaticism. That's such a pejorative. People love Lego. They are crazy about it. I knew because my nephews, who are the kids in my family, you know, from the ages of about like 7 till now they're like the ages of like 10 to 15. But from the ages of 7 to like 13, every Christmas it was Lego. They wanted Lego, Lego, Lego. And they would make the coolest crap. So, I mean, it makes sense. Kids want to create. Kids want to make things. Adults want to make, and we all want to make things. That's what we're doing. We're making an interview. We're making this movie. We all want to create things, and this is just like the most fundamental blocks. It's the building blocks of creation, and I just coined that. So feel free, Lego, to use that. But you did see it here first, so there's a small fee. We'll talk about that later. Well, let's just say it's awesome. Everything is awesome. It's really neat. I'm honored. Chris and Phil, the directors, great filmmakers. They've worked so incredibly hard on this movie. I mean, I worked like maybe 15 days over the course of a year. I get a lot of the credit, but all of the hard work that goes into it, boy, not only just creating the story, the rights, the rewrites, seeing what's working, cutting what's not working, like, polishing, but on top of that, the hundreds of animators just sitting around frame by frame creating these Lego worlds. I mean, there's oceans made of Lego bricks, clouds made of Lego bricks, everything is Lego in this whole movie. That's not easy, I don't think. I don't know. I have no idea how you make a movie like this. Outside of just showing up in my pajamas, reading the words, riffing, having a lot of fun, doing all my faces, I don't know what else went into it. But yet here I am getting all the credit, and you know what? I deserve it. I mean, there were moments that felt... I mean, yes. I was going to say there were moments that felt like work, but that's not really true. There were moments where it was like, ugh. My voice is sore. But then I think back to, like, the stuff my dad did for a living. Like, he would slap me so hard across the face to say that my sore voice from 4 hours of talking really felt like work, you know? No, I mean, it's pretty breezy. It's kind of the best way to earn a living, I think. I hope that they'll consider me for Lego Movie 2 if they ever make one. Please. And 3. And up to 10. 11, we'll talk renegotiation, but we're getting a little ahead of ourselves. I just hope people love the movie. I think they will. I love the movie, and I'm pretty sure that I have the same critical thinking skills as your typical 7-year-old, so kids are going to love this movie because I loved it. It's just the general test. Your 5-year-old going to like it? Show it to Chris. Did he cheer? It'll work.